CataractCoach.com. Toric planning for high astigmatism. 4 diopters in the right eye and 5 or more diopters in the left eye. And our guest surgeon is Dr. Anastasi from France. Let's look at the right eye first. Here's a scan of the right eye showing the tomography. And you see that big yellow figure of 8? That, of course, is the astigmatism. It looks reasonably symmetric and regular, and it's with the rule, so steep axis is about 90 degrees. We can look below that, and you can see the pachymetry values, and it's a thick cornea, 640 in the center. And that's, of course, quite thick. And then the elevation of the anterior and posterior cornea is shown there as well, and those look pretty reasonable. Now, this device reads that the anterior cornea has 4 diopters of astigmatism, 4.1, and the posterior has 0.7. When you look at that cornea pachymetry, you think, God, 640 is pretty thick. Let's make sure it's a normal eye. Right? We'd expect the corneal pachymetry to be somewhere in the 530, 540 is average, with a standard deviation of about 30 or 40. So this is 2 or more standard deviations above the mean for the astigmatism, but 2 or more standard deviations above the mean also for the pachymetry. Let's look at the left eye. Left eye, even more astigmatism. It's slightly askew, still with the rule. Steep axis, about 110 degrees. Anterior cornea is measuring 5.7 diopters of astigmatism. Posterior, 0.9. Again, pachymetry quite thick at 630. And the anterior and posterior floats look pretty normal. So this is a case where you have to pause for a second and just make sure nothing else is going on with the eye. Why is the pachymetry so thick? Is that just the way the eye developed? Or is there a weak endothelium and some swelling in the cornea? Important to check that. Is this astigmatism just purely regular and refractive, or is there some corneal pathology? Is there pterygium growing on both eyes to cause this? Is there a keratoconus or pellucid or some other corneal degeneration? It's very unusual to have such a high degree of astigmatism, but it does exist. In the US, the highest power toric lenses we have correct astigmatism of only 4 diopters at the corneal plane. So in Europe, I think they have access to a wider range. But luckily for this patient, everything else pretty much checks out normal. Let's look at the lens calcs. So here's right eye and left eye lens calculation. So small eye, 21.87 axial length on the right, 21.51 on the left. And this device also measures about 4 diopters for the right eye in terms of astigmatism, and about 5.6 diopters in the left eye of astigmatism. And let's look on the right side of the page here where you have the calculations. And this is recommending a 23 diopter lens with 5 degrees of astigmatism on the IOL, which of course is going to be less at the spectacle plane or the corneal plane for that matter. And on the left eye, it's recommending 23.5 with 7.5 diopters of toric correction on the IOL itself, which will, of course, be less at the corneal plane. And you can see the prediction here is for a basically perfectly plano outcome in both eyes. So these are the lenses that were implanted. I've confirmed with the doctor. And there's the intraoperative device being used to really align that lens to the correct meridian. And let's see the post-op results. So pre-op, you can see this patient was myopic to begin with. So spherical equivalent on the right eye pre-op was minus 2.5. The left eye was about minus 1. And the now post-op, when we look in green here, look what the outcome is. It's a beautiful outcome for the patient, but it's not plano like the calculator predicted. So you can see this patient now post-op has about 1 diopter myopia in the right eye with very little or no astigmatism. And the left eye has about 1.5 of myopia with another 1 diopter of astigmatism. So spherical equivalent in the post-op result is minus 1 or so in the right eye, minus 2 or so in the left eye. And that's pretty darn good. This is a young patient, and you know, young people especially are always glued to their phones and their computers, and to have a mild myopic outcome in this case certainly is a blessing. So beautiful case, nicely done. And next time, Dr. Kasi, submit us a surgical video also. I know you love the YouTube videos, but check out the website, cataractcoach.com. A lot easier to navigate. We have a complete list of articles and videos. You can go and check on any of these categories and explore more. You can also search. There's a search engine that's really effective. You can see Gore-Tex lenses like this. And finally, you can look up about me. There's a link that has my surgical instruments. Now you don't even have to ask me. You can just find out for yourself. What's the name of those forceps?